But impossible. Hey, I'm not gonna tell anyone you should try this or that. Look, if you're not old enough, or like if you ain't 21, in my opinion, I wouldn't suggest trying anything. I would wait. I'd definitely wait till you're 21, and you could definitely be more free. Like, for example, marijuana, you could be 18, but you would have to get a medical card and go through all that. But if you're 21, you don't have to worry about that. Obviously, people have their way of getting the bootleg version. It's always been like that. But nowadays with dispensary, where you could just walk in and actually buy that, especially in some states where it's legal, like Cali, Nevada, to name a couple for you, Colorado, of course, you could buy that, toss it in your trunk, and cop pull you over, see that in your trunk. You can't do nothing about it. You know what I mean? That's the best part right there. It's like, go ahead, try to take my weed, sucker. But, no, man, like, going back to my point, though, I don't want to get it off track too much. Because I've had cough syrup. I definitely took cough syrup when I was a kid. And that's basically what codeine is. And when they mix it with a Sprite, it's supposed to, it does make you feel good. It does. It puts your mind in a nice, relaxing mood. And as long as you're not overdosing yourself, you won't die like how Pimp C did from drinking lean. And it just feels nice and it feels soothing, man. Man. That's all I can say. That right there, this song right there, hails everything that's authentic about H-Town right here. Impossible is that song, man. This song, definitely, probably the most H-Town influenced song out of all of them that he's ever made. So with that being said, let's move on to track number 11. Maria, I'm drunk.
Yeah.
Could hear me, but that was definitely a cold freestyle. That shit just came off the dome. But let me just put that shit aside. I was just having fun right there. This song was really fun, and to me, whoever came up with the idea of adding Justin Bieber in between Young Thug and Travis Scott made that shit go really smooth like an Oreo, no pun intended. But alright, you got Travis coming and doing his thing. Young Thug, always an eccentric feature. And to me, a great person to work with Travis Scott in general. I think they went on tour together, if I'm not mistaken. I'm gonna need a collab between these two, like how we got Quavo and Travis Scott doing a collab. I need a project between these two, okay? Let's get that Jack Slime coming out. So, Justin Bieber came in and was the perfect feature for the second verse. Came in and did it smooth. I heard the first leak. The leak was pretty cool. It's alright. It was dope. But they revamped this on another level, and the inclusion of Justin Bieber made it significantly even better. Like, it's crazy. But the one thing that always bugged me, and Travis, I wonder why you left it like this, because to me, dog, the way you take us on a journey, on a psychedelic travel through space, to me, this was like an ultimate dope nature song here that would put someone on that MDMA shit. I'm just being real with you. Like some nature shit right here. Like Electric Slide type of vibe. Like how, you know what I mean? Like you had this really, not Electric Slide, Electric Eel. If anyone knows who I'm talking about, that song by MDMA, that's what I meant by MDMA shit. Like Electric Eel, like that nature crazy pop electric song, man. Like that song, the one Nipsey Hussle sampled for Walk to the Bank from damn, The Marathon. But I don't know if any of y'all heard that mixtape, but that's for the real cats to understand me. But sun got me feeling like an electric eel, something like that. I forgot how it goes, but he had that vibe with Maria. That's what I'm trying to get at, y'all. I'm sorry that I dragged that for too long, but Maria was too short for me. Calling for Maria, calling for Maria, calling for Maria. Trust me, baby, trust me. Trust me, baby, trust me. Trust me, baby, trust me. I don't mind. Trust me, baby, trust me. Trust me, baby, trust me. Trust me, baby, trust me. I don't mind. That's basically it. I just sang the whole song. That's how long it is. Okay? It's like less than a minute long, and to me that's a crime. When people make a beautiful melody and they just let it fade off like that. Dog. You could have turned Maria into a whole crazy ass song, bro. Honestly, it kind of gives me Shadow the Hedgehog vibe too, with the Maria name in it and being out in space on the Ark and all that. But it's like, if you could have done it something like that, you could have based it off like Sonic, and then at the same time you could have made some Adam and Eve shit. It's like God sent two people to go explore a whole wilderness by themselves, just a man and a woman. It would have been dope. The girl would have been scared and be like, trust me. Yeah, that shit would have been dope. And to me, you could have created like some kind of like Adam and Eve theme kind of joint with that song, and like walk around with this beautiful chick, you know what I mean? And then like explore, like could have been like in the Amazons or some shit in like South America. You could have recorded it there and it would have been dope, bro. And to me, it would have shown that wild side of yours once more on a different landscape. So for me, I felt like he kind of missed out on capitalizing that part of the song. I know he probably only meant it to be a transition into I'm Drunk, and that's how Travis is. He always loves his transitions. But man, dog, that right there, that's some hidden gold right there. That if one day you were to revisit Rodeo, revisit that song again, and maybe make an extended version, oh man, that would be dope. Because to me, especially if you get Kylie to be in the music video with you and you do that song Maria, oh man. And all you had to do was sing like how you did there, bro. You could sing and it would feel so heavenly, dog. Oh man, that's all I gotta say. But yeah, I'm Drunk is a dope joint. Young Thug was cool. Like I said, Travis did his thing. But to me, Justin Bieber really was a big key figure on that new version, man. That being said, let's move on to track number 12. And that's none other than Flying High featuring Toro y Moi.
Sip here, please don't reply. Say it.
shit to go pee on, yeah.
Oh, that's true. It seems
there's the chillest of all them all, man. It really is. And Travis Scott basically summed it up best. All we want is peace and love. And this song just gives you that vibe, man. Toro y Moy, I'd like to see them again, man. That was dope. This isn't the first time we've seen them. That was back on Al Ferro. But, like, to me, that's the thing, though. They were there on his first mixtape. So, like, to me, they're like the OG feature. Because they were there with them, man. Oh, man. So, let me go ahead and give you guys an update list of the production credit. Because I forgot to do that. I believe after Nightcrawler. So, Piss in Your Grave. That was Kanye West. Heat, Goldstein, Dean, Travis Scott, King. Antidote. Obviously, Wonder Girl, the leader who made that beat. Travis Scott, Eastbound. We need more Travis Scott Wonder Girl collaboration. That's all I'm gonna tell you right now. Wonder Girl beyond that. Ritter, Dean, Travis Scott, Impossible. There you go. Maria M. Drunk, Ritter, Travis Scott, Frank Dukes, Bidet, Dean. Whoever was the one mainly responsible for making Maria, extend that beat, and it's possible. You can make it some type of, like, give it the same drum pattern that you did for Pornography for the first part of the beat. Just give it something like soft, you know, some snare that hits pretty soft, you know, kick too. Keep things well balanced, you know what I mean? Give it that lo-fi feel. And then Travis could come in and just sing and kind of like take you on a nice journey. And then at times you can let the 808 just ride out for a good bar or two. And it's beautiful, man. It's a beautiful track that, honestly, I could see Travis visiting again, extend that whole song. And, yeah, basically making it his next big hit single since Antidote. That's what I believe. Flying High, the one we just listened to. So, obviously the chill vibes, you know, there's only one guy who can make vibes like that and just make it chill no matter what generation he's in the 2000s, 2010s, 2020. You know the man. His name is Pharrell, the guy who made the song Happy. That's it. Mike Dean, Travis Scott, Ritter, those were the guys that were right there with Pharrell. But you know Pharrell was the captain on that track. We're gonna move on to track number 13, and this is pretty much the OG3 when it comes to the production, you know, oversee. And that's of course Mike Dean, Alan Ritter, and the main mastermind Travis Scott himself. I can tell. Producer for I Can Tell FKI. I guess they didn't put it underneath. I didn't see that. But a funny thing is, I don't know if they put it on bottom head. I feel like there was uncredited vocals by background vocals by Young Thug. Let me see. let me see. I did hear Pharrell Williams a little bit in the background vocals for Flying High. I remember that. Okay, I guess that's it. Yeah, I could have sworn I heard Young Thug. I guess Travis Scott was really that good with the singing, but it sounds like Thug, dog, on the hook. I can tell, baby, I can tell. I don't know. Maybe it's just my ears tricking on me. Let's get to track number 14, man. Well, no, before I do that, hold on. I can tell, bro. It's one of those songs, man, that, for me, at first, I just rocked with the vibe. I thought I can tell was like, oh, I can tell, like, you lying or you going through the facade. That's how I first thought when I heard this song when it came out. But then as I listened to it, it's like, no, it's more like, I can tell. I can tell you more about my story, what I did, how we came up, how we come to. And I'm like, okay, now I see what he's talking about. Like, if you want to hear my story, I can tell. That's basically what the message of the song is. It's like, I'm not just going to tell you what my life's about, which is cool. Because then it's like, he's basically saying like, hey, I'm not doing this to show off. I just love making music. So if you want to know how I did things, yeah, I can tell you how we did this, how we did that and shit like that. So he's saying, I can tell, but it's like, I'm not just going to tell you. Kind of like that. But either way, let me not confuse y'all. I like the song. It's a dope vibe. Everything about it just continues to carrying Rodeo around. So, you know what? Yeah. This album is flawless, man. If there was a song where I felt like it was technically the weakest link, it might be that song, to be honest with you. But nonetheless, it's still a damn good song. Like, if Travis Scott was to drop that as Lucy or just Let It Go, I definitely would be arguing for that to be on Rodeo for sure. So, honestly, you know, like I said, this album flows perfect. There's not a bad song on here. I don't even know why I call it the weakest link. It sounds weird because it's not a weak song at all. But yeah, that being said, let me see if I can set y'all up for the last song real quick. I think I know what cut I'm gonna do. Yep, let's get it. Apple pie.
powerful. The evolution's absolute. Tours and shows with groupie whores. Would hesitate if he had to shoot. Though we'd rather not. Forever been the elephant in the room. Everyone can't wait to run and tell about. The head to the body of the belligerent militant group. The sponsors the revolution that will not be televised. Decide to cross those little guys. You've obviously been ill-advised. Yet and still, the question that arises to the mind: will he make it? Was it worth it? Did he win? Will he survive the rodeo?
Fuck it. Oh man, apple pie.
I don't want your apple pie, mama.
Yo, that song's dope, man. Apple pie, man. That's definitely my favorite song from this album, man. That's my favorite. I still think the best song overall is Pray for Love. But dog. Wow. That song is just perfect. That song's so perfect for me.